Hey, what's up you guys, and welcome back to Gal. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can bring your video to life through sound. So you guys, right now I actually have the Manfrotto Lumi Muse light strapped to my shoe right now, and it's illuminating my face because it got so dark. Anyway, I just thought it was funny and I had to tell you that. Basically, this video is about how sound can really bring your video to life. And Peter McKinnon made a great video about showing how sound effects and adding ambience to your video can make it sound so much better and so much more professional. So what I'm going to do right now is roll a few clips of B-roll that I shot here in the forest, accompanied with some sound effects that I got from SoundSnap, which is an awesome site where you can download heaps of awesome sounds from clicks to pops to people running, ambience, musical beats, a whole bunch of stuff. And I accompanied it with some of the sound that I recorded with my H4N Zoom recorder. So let me roll the clips here so you guys can listen to the difference. So what you just heard was a compilation of a bunch of different sounds to make the video more believable and more real. Not every sound effect you heard in there was recorded in the scene, which is awesome. I actually took tons of sounds from SoundSnap, like birds chirping, the steps, just the ambience, all of that came from SoundSnap, and I used some of the recorded sound that I recorded from my H4N. So how did I layer these sounds and make them sound more real? Now this is where we're going to jump into Premiere Pro and show you how I use the Essential Sound Panel to make it sound more authentic. So let's jump in. All right, you guys, so we're inside of Premiere Pro here, and here I have the sequence of shots just with the music track in the timeline here, so you can see it's just the shots that I showed you before, and what I'm going to do is show you how to add the sound effects. So the first step here is I'm in the audio workspace. Make sure that you are as well if you're following along. So that way you have the Essential Sound panel open. If you don't have this open, just go to Window, Essential Sound. So the first step is to normalize the audio of the music track so it's not too powerful. So first select it. Now let's click on music as the audio type, and this will give you a whole bunch of different controls. And what I like to do is just auto match, and you can see that it reduces the actual loudness of the music clip. So if I play it back right now, it's like between minus 12 and like negative 24 decibels. So if you wanted to make this a little bit more quieter, you could just reduce the clip volume here just by reducing this down, let's say to minus 5 or minus 7. It's really just up to listening and seeing how it sounds. So I think we'll just leave it at this for now, and then we'll decide after we add in the sound effects if it's still too loud. So the first sound effect that I want to add in is the general forest ambience. Now, I got this forest ambience from SoundSnap. So what I did is I just searched for ambience and I downloaded it and I dragged it here into my folder. So if I double click, you can listen to identify the portion of the ambience that you want to select and use in your edit. So let's just play this back. So let's say we wanted to start here, just hit I for in, and let's just scrub forward and hit O for out. And then this audio here, I'm going to drag it down just here onto one of the audio tracks. It doesn't matter which one right now because we will reorganize. So let's just play this back with the music. And with this off, if you just hit M here and then turn it back on, it already gave it so much more texture and atmosphere, like we were inside of the forest. So now what we want to do is just make sure it is leveled correctly. So just click on that. And now, believe it or not, there's an ambience tag for audio type. So just click on this. And here, what we can do is we can choose a preset if we wanted to. I'm actually just going to auto match it to make sure that the loudness level is correct for broadcast standard. That is what LUFS is. It's just the broadcast standard. I wouldn't worry too much about it, but I always like to set it and listen back. If it's still too loud, let's just play it. So right now it's a little bit loud, but what I like to do is just reduce the clip volume. So I'm just going to reduce this like by -9 and let's see how it sounds. Now we need to add in more nuanced sounds like the water. So I actually recorded with my H4n Zoom the stream of water here. So I'm going to go to this folder in my project panel. And the audio clip I used was 003. So let's open that up and let's just listen back. So I'm just going to start the clip here, hit I for N. And then I'll hit O for out. And then I'm just going to drag it like before. And you can see here in the timeline, by the way, a quick tip, if you need to expand a layer in your timeline, just double click next to it in this empty space, double click, and it expands it, which is pretty cool. And double click to close it. So here at this moment, there is still water, right? So we need to drag out this audio sound effect of the stream. And now if we play it back, let's just listen to see what we have to do. So what we need to do first is make sure that the loudness standard is correct. So just click on it, go to sound effects now from Essential Sound. And what we can do now is add presets based on where this sound is coming from. So this is pretty close up here, and so is this. So what we're going to do is choose a preset called Make Close Up, and see how it just boosted the audio levels there. That's because it automatically applied the auto match to this clip. Now if we play it back, you'll hear that it is quite a bit louder. And I think it's actually too loud because it's getting almost up to zero, which means it's peaking. So what I need to do is just reduce the volume a bit. Let's say down to like -8 and let's play back. That's sounding better. But what I want to do here is at this moment, it's a more distant shot. So what I'm going to do is just hit C to cut at this moment where the clip changes. And then I'm going to select this clip. And then rather than make close up, I'm going to select make distant, because that's going to match what our actual ear would be hearing if we were standing at this location in the shot, right? It's all about proximity and distance to the subject and the sound. So here, it automatically boosted it and it's pretty loud. And I don't want it to be that loud. So what I'm going to do is reduce this way down to -13 and let's see if we can hear the difference in sound between these two clips. And it's believable because it's based on where the viewer would be seeing this subject,
the water and hearing it in real life. So that is the first three clips. Now let's move on to this clip. So to make this nicely fade out, by the way, what I like to do is zoom in here and then I right click to add a default transition. And then I just kind of extend it out a bit so that way it transitions nicely out into the next clip. So it just adds a default transition on the audio clip. So then here, what I did was I kept the forest ambience like we have here because we want that forest ambience. It's the same scene. So let's just extend that to make sure it's the exact length of the little sequence we have here. But now what I want to do, in addition to having the forest ambience, is to add some birds. So I took some woodpecker sounds from SoundSnap, double click, and it's very quiet if you play it back. Do you hear that? It's so quiet, it's almost too quiet. So what we need to do is actually brighten this up inside of the timeline. So let's just go ahead and drag this little portion of it down. And then let's click on it, go to sound effects again, and let's choose make medium shot. And you can see it just boosted the audio waveform. So if I double click, you can see before I did that, there was nothing. But then when I hit make medium shot, look what happened. See? Now let's play it back. So you can really hear the birds now, and you can also hear all of the background noise as well, which I want to try to reduce a little bit. So what I'm going to do is identify the moment that I want the birds to come in. So right here, I want to cut just by rolling that edit back. Then I'm going to move this over here. I'm going to add a cross dissolve just by right clicking and applying a default transition so it fades in. Now the birds are very present, right? But I still think that the background is a little bit too loud. So what I'm going to do is just reduce the clip volume just a bit down to like -8, and let's see how it sounds. And now it sounds a lot better. It's almost like you're painting with sound, right? It's a very subtle, nuanced process of really just bringing your video to life and painting in the sound. Now, we may want to get rid of some of the noise, so I'm going to actually search for the denoise audio effect. I'm just going to drag and drop it on this clip. Now from effect controls, we can actually hit edit, and from here, we can choose light noise reduction. Now let me play it back, and I'll turn the effect on and off so you can hear what it sounds like with the noise reduction. That's with it off and on. And it just very subtle. Just listen back again. This is with it on, off, and on. So it's just a very subtle amount of noise reduction, which I like. So that's all for this clip. So I'm just going to roll this edit back and also add a default cross dissolve at the end of that. Now here, this is the fun one where I'm actually matching footsteps that I got from SoundSnap. So you can see here, I have some footsteps that I downloaded. If I double click, so you can listen. And what I want to do is match them to when my feet hit the ground here. So just to choose a footstep that you like, you can actually hit I for in and O for out. And then I'm just going to drag that down into the timeline and then match it right when my foot starts to hit the ground. And just got to line it up right when my foot hits the ground, right about there. And then my second foot is right about here. So then I just go back to take another sound using in and out and drag it to when my foot basically hits the ground right about here. And it kind of blends into the next scene, which I think is a cool transition. Some people may want to fade it out before this scene. It really just depends on your preference. So let's just listen to that. So it's just really subtle, right? Now, to make a little bit more atmosphere once we get to the forest scene, maybe there's some more woodpeckers here, but let's not choose the same sound because we don't want to repeat the same birds. I actually downloaded another woodpecker sound from SoundSnap. There's a ton of bird effects, but there's a lot of woodpeckers in this neck of the woods. So let's just double click and you can listen back. So it's a bit more intense, more wild. Let's just go ahead and drag this down here. And I don't want all of the birds chirping. I'm just going to take two of the sounds. So I'm just going to roll this edit back, and then I'm going to cut right here and delete this portion of the clip, then just drag it over. So now when we play it back, the birds come in after or while the second step is happening. Now it's just too loud. It's cool, but it's too loud. So what I'm going to do is just click on this, go to sound effects again, and this time I'm going to choose make distant. And you can see it just reduced the level of this audio again, just slightly. So what I'm going to do is just reduce it even more because it wasn't enough, and let's play it back. So you can see that everything is just nicely under around minus 12 to minus 18. A little bit lower than that is just fine. Once again, you don't want anything up in the 0, minus 6, because that's when it starts to get a little bit too loud. You want it to be nice and subtle. So the last step for me is just to add some fades to the end of the sequence to kind of close out the video. So at the end, I just right click to apply a default cross dissolve, and let me just zoom in so you can see it better. I'm just going to drag the end of it and pull it out. And now from effects, I'm going to search for exponential fade, which is an audio crossfade. And then I'm going to drag and drop it to apply it to the end of this clip, and then roll it out to meet the cross dissolve. And then I'm going to click on this, Command C to copy, and then I'm going to hold Shift to select the two other remaining audio clips and press Command V to paste it. And now it just fades out nicely. See? Pretty cool. So the last step is just to watch it through just to make sure there's nothing else that stands out or doesn't feel right. And so nothing seemed too loud there. Again, it's just a process of going through and making sure nothing is too loud, or really kind of sitting down and thinking, what is authentic here? So audio editing does take some time, but I have so much fun with it, and I hope that you guys now have the tools to make your audio sound awesome as well.
So thanks so much for watching, everyone. A special shout out to SoundSnap for sponsoring this video. If you guys want to try it out for free, be sure to check it out with the link below, and you guys can get set up with a free month or something like that. Just reach out to SoundSnap and they'll hook you up. And if you guys are looking for headphones to mix, I definitely recommend these Mezzi 99 Classics. Not only do they smell like wilderness, literally it's walnut. It's pretty amazing. You guys should check this out. And if you want to record your own sound, you can check out the H4N Zoom, which I use to just record using the mics that are built in. So when you're outside like I am, you can get some pretty awesome sounds that you can layer in your video like I showed you inside of Premiere Pro. So that's all, you guys. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if it helped you out. Subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new videos on the channel. See you guys next time. Bye. We can't help but be a little fragile through the clatters inside and crackles are the sounds of a natural rattle vibrating us all. The natural rattle.